Hey guys, welcome to this video. Today we're gonna customize the i3 installation that we did in the last video. So this is where we ended up, and we said okay, we need to set the screen size as well as that kind of thing. So first things first, we need to open terminal with mod key, so the Windows key and enter, super key enter, and we're gonna install a program called A-Render. So Pacman -S A R and R, and type in the password, and we're gonna install it. So now we can close the terminal again. Mod Shift Q. So these are the basics. Then we go mod D for the D menu, and we're gonna type A R and R, and there it is already. And we're gonna open it, and we're gonna set the resolution to 1920 by 1080. We're gonna apply that, and then we're gonna save that file to monitor.sh. So this is how we can set the screen. Mod Shift Q, we can close this, but we have to set this in our config file. So let's first start up a new terminal. I want the other terminal because I can then increase the size a bit. So I will do mod D and then termite, and then we increase the size. So we're gonna edit the config file now. So vim.config /i3, that's the folder, /conf. And we're going to the end, shift-gg. Already at the end of the file, and we're gonna append the following: exec and we're gonna do --no --startup -id, so this is that it doesn't get the ID, and then we have to copy the what's in that file. So I'm gonna open that file now, and tap. We're gonna go to not desktop, so dot screen layout, and I'm gonna open the modify, and we're gonna copy this line. And we're gonna open the .config i3 config file again, and we're at the end, so enter. So this is the way that we have to set the screen size now. So I'm gonna save this, and we're gonna log out and then log back in again. And now you can see that the screen size is set correctly. So what else do we need to change? We need to change the font size for the lower bar, because I think this is very small. And also this is pretty small. So we're gonna start the terminal again. I'm gonna start termite. I'm gonna zoom in. And I'm gonna do the vim config again. And I'm going to the top. With gg, you go to the top of the file. So font, this is the font that is used at this moment, font monospace. I'm gonna leave it at monospace, no problems there, but I'm gonna change the size a bit. So I'm gonna set it to, let's say, L11. And what I also want to change is, I'm gonna do for the terminal, and I'm gonna set it here to termite. So because this is saying i3 sensible terminal, but I'm gonna set it to termite, and I'm gonna escape WQ. So now it's saved. I'm gonna restart i3 with mod shift and R, and you can see now that the at the bottom the screen size is a lot bigger. And also, if I do a mod D, you can see here, this is now also a bit bigger. So those are the first things that we did. The next thing is, as you, I will go to the second screen. You can still see that we have a nice black background, and I want to change that to have a normal background. So we're gonna open here Firefox, and we're gonna search for a nice wallpaper. So let's search for Arch Linux wallpaper. And let's take this one. And we're gonna take a nice one. Let's take this one, download it. And we're gonna save this as, let's do it directly in pictures. And we're gonna save this as wallpaper.jpg. Save it. We're gonna close Firefox again. Go back to the first workspace with mod 1. And we have to install a program called Nitrogen, because I don't think that we installed it already. Let me check it. Yeah, we did install it already. So now we can run Nitrogen. So mod D for the D menu, Nitrogen. And we're gonna go to preferences, add, and we're gonna select the pictures folder, select that one, press OK. And here you can see that wallpaper. We're gonna set it to zoom field so that everything is done, and we're gonna set it to apply. And we can close this screen again. And you can see the wallpaper is now set. To have this being set after reboot or after refresh of the configuration file of i3 again, we need to set this in the config file. So let's open the config file again, go to the end, and we're gonna set it to, oh, I didn't make a mirror here. Let's insert here. So let's hit here set screen resolution. It's going to be enter. We're gonna here set wallpaper, and we're gonna do exec underscore always. So we always want to set the screen size with dash dash no dash startup dash ID, and it is called Nitrogen, and you do dash dash restore, and this will restore the wallpaper that you have set. So I do have another option. If you have multiple wallpapers already loaded on your system and you want to change them every time you log in to a new wallpaper, we can set it as dash dash, instead of restore, you set it to random. And dash dash set dash zoom dash fail. And now every time you log in, this will make sure that you have a new wallpaper every time you log in. So this is a nice option. I have that set on my machine so that I, when I log in, I get a new wallpaper every time, or when I do a refresh of i3, I get a new wallpaper. And this is pretty good. Okay, so we also had a program that we installed, was a lock for a lock screen. And if I do i3 lock, you can see that we now get a nice white screen, and if you, it's locked, so you cannot do anything. You can, and then I do enter and verify, and it cannot find my password. So if I do type my password correctly, I can log in. But I don't want to start i3 lock with just typing i3 lock. I want that in my config file and under a shortcut key. So let's go into the config file again, and we're gonna set this. So I'm gonna type in here i3 lock, and we're gonna set it like this. So we're gonna do a bind sim is for you bind two keys together, so that's why it's called bind sim. And we're gonna do mod key. And I want to have it plus L. So for the lock, or no, let's put it to mod X for exit. And you're gonna exec i3 lock. So here we have i3 lock now set to mod key plus X. So I'm gonna escape W right Q. And we're gonna restart i3 with mod shift and R. If I now do mod L or mod X, I'm gonna into my lock screen. So type in the password again, and that's done. Now here at the bottom, you can see that we have workspaces called 1, and if I do Alt mod key and 2, it's 2, mod 3. It's 3, mod 4 is 4, but I'd rather see what the workspaces are for. So we're gonna change that one. So we're gonna go back to the config file, and we're gonna go up again, and we're gonna go down until I see the workspaces. So these are the workspace settings here. So these are the settings that you see for the 1, 2, 3, and 4, and that kind of stuff. So I want to change that to something like colon, insert colon, and let's do terminal 2 for Firefox, 3 for, let's say something like KDE Live. So you get what I mean. So now we're gonna save this. And if I now go to workspace 2, you don't see anything yet because we didn't restart. So restart i3, mod shift 2, you can see that it's Firefox. And the first workspace isn't changed yet because this workspace is still open. And we have something opened on that. So you have to restart i3 again. So you have to exit and log back in again. And then you set that correctly. So let's do that for now. Exit. Log back in again. And now you can see that number 1 is terminal. But what I think is nicer, to have something like an icon beneath or besides the text that we set there, or just an icon that's gives an indication of what this workspace is for. So let's install something like Font Awesome. En het is ttf-font-awesome. En type in the password. And when this is installed, we can go to Workspace 2, open Firefox, and you can type in your search cheat sheet font awesome, and you get here a nice cheat sheet for font awesome. I close this one. And so let's do something for the terminal. So Control F and you do terminal, and here you can see a nice font. So you can copy this. We go to Workspace ONE again, and we're gonna edit the config file, and we have the terminal here. So let's paste in what we copied. So Control Shift V, and now we have a nice indicator that it's there. We can leave it as this, so we can do that one. Let's go to Workspace 2 again and find something for Firefox. So Firefox has its own logo here. You can copy that one, go back to Page one again, and we're gonna paste it in again here. And KDN Live is more like a video editor, so let's search for something like video. So nice video camera. Copy this, and we're going back to the first workspace again, and we're gonna paste it in here. So if I close this now, escape WQ, and we're gonna restart i3 again. If I now go to the third workspace, you can see that it has a nice icon besides KDN Live. So to have that on workspace 2 and 1 again, you have to log out and log back in again, and then it's done. So now we have nice icons, so let's go to Workspace 2, let's close this one, Workspace 1, but we want to make sure that if you open something like Firefox, it opens also on that Firefox tab of Workspace that we created. So we added the config file again, and we're going to set something besides the workspaces here. So after the workspaces, we're gonna enter something, and we're gonna set here bind programs to specific workspaces. So let's say I want to have the terminals always open on workspace 1. So we're going to do assign, and then bracket, and the class is, now to be able to find the class of the terminal, we're going to do open another terminal, and there's a program called xprop, and we're gonna click enter. And now if I click on this space, we should be able to see what is opened. So the program is called termite, and here we can see termite and termite, and I think we have to get the first one. Now we have to use the second one, so termite with a capital T. And we're gonna set that as the class. So we're gonna type termite, and we're gonna close it, and we're gonna set that to workspace 1. And then in the second line, we're going to set for window. Another curly braces class is termite. And we're going to make sure that it focuses on that workspace. So I made the typo, so termite, but it is focus with a U, need focus with an E, but focus with a U. So if I now go to workspace 2 and I would refresh workspace 2 and then I press mod enter, it should go to workspace 1 automatically with a new terminal. So it does. So let's go on and do the same for something like Firefox. So we can just copy these two lines. Yank, gonna go below and we're gonna paste. And we're gonna assign the Firefox. And we do the same here. But we want to open this one on workspace 2. So let's set it to workspace 2. Press escape, W right Q. We go to workspace 2 and we open Firefox directly. So this is the way to set certain programs to start on a certain workspace. So mod enter, I still go back to workspace 1. And if I would do Firefox again, so open Firefox, it will open Firefox on workspace 2, always. So if we go into the configuration file again, because I want to have my programs start automatically on based on a shortcut key. So I go to the end of the file and I'm gonna enter a new line for my apps. So start applications and we're gonna bind sim like we did before, dollar mod plus W, so this is my web browser, and we're gonna exec slash usr slash bin slash Firefox. Escape, mod WQ, mod shift R to restart, and it says we have an error, so there must be something here wrong. So it says we have already an entry from mod plus W, so let's search for it. So slash mod plus W. It's a layout tabbed. Do we have something in mod plus F? Yeah, it's full screen. Mod B, do we have that one already? No, so let's set it to mod B then, so mod browser. You see, and when you try to do something that's already set, you get an automatic error. So mod shift R to reload. And if I now do mod key plus B, it will open Firefox on the workspace too. So I set keys for starting up my programs. I also changed something around because, yeah, I like my key bindings a bit different than the default, but I set it on my machine. But this is the default one and we want to keep the default one for this video. So this is set. And now we want to have, we have now set the the font size. We make sure that we start up. We created something different for the workspaces so that we can see what the workspace is what. We said that we have programs starting up on that workspace. We can set bind sims to start up applications with a shortcut key. And we also want to now to have something like the i3 status bar here at the bottom. You can see that it has a bit too much information. This is not a laptop, so we have no battery here. I don't want it. Wi-Fi, I don't have Wi-Fi, so I don't want to see this. No IP version 6, I don't want to see this. So we're going to change this a bit. Let's first try and do a locate where the i3 status bar config file is. So locate i3 blocks, i3 block, i3 status. Locate is not installed, so sudo pacman dash sm locate. I really should learn how to type. So let's install it. Let's clear the screen. Sudo db update. Update db. So now the database for locate is updated. So now we can locate i3 status. And we can see here that the configuration file is etc i3 status config. So I want to have my own. So in .config, we're going to make a directory. .config slash i3 status. And we're going to copy slash etc slash i3 status.conf to .config slash i3 status. And now we can edit that config file. And here's the config file. And you see here the interval is set to 5. You see the time at the bottom here, it will update every 5 seconds. I want it to be every second, so I'm going to delete it and I'm going to set this to 1. So here is the orders. Like I said, I don't want the IP version 6, so I'm just going to comment it out. So hashtag in front of it, the wireless, the same thing. So Ethernet is good. I don't have a battery, so here I can set the battery. And this is already very good. And also, we can set some nice icons as well to the same thing here, right? So let's try it. So let's find a nice icon for disk. So we're gonna open Firefox with modb. And we're gonna go to the cheat sheet again. And let's search something for a hard disk. So let's copy this one. Go back to here. Okay, but to be able to have i3 status look at this config file, we need to change the config for i3 to be able to say, okay, you have to look at this i3 config file. So here you see a status command i3 status, and we're gonna append to it dash c slash home /tdl/.config/ i3status. /i3status.conf. And we're going to write it. And now we're going to restart i3 again. And now you can see here that we have restarted i3. And all the other things are gone, but I don't have the hard disk icon on my bar. So probably I set it to the wrong place. So let's start it again. Do yank it and delete it. I'm gonna set it somewhere else where the battery status format, disk format. And let's put it here. So now you can see here the nice icon next to the space on the disk. So we could do that for another one. So let's see, what do we have here? Wireless is Ethernet, battery all, disk load, memory. So let's do it for the time. Let's set something nice for the time. Not two, so let's do something for clock. So this is a nice clock. Copy that one, mod one, and we're gonna paste it here. Gonna save it and reload i3. And now you can see we have a nice icon besides the clock. So this is pretty good. And we can already change those kind of things. Okay, so this is done. As you can see, the terminal is still very not opaque, so we cannot see the background. So it's pretty dark. I want to see some opacity on the terminal. So let's set that. But first we have to copy the termite configuration file to the .config folder. So we can make a directory, mkdir slash, no, .config slash termite. Press enter and locate termite. Oops, and let's set it to more. And the config file is in xtg termite config, so let's copy that. So cp and we're gonna copy that to .config termite and we're gonna edit the termite file. So let's do that. vim.config termite config. And let's set also the startup size for the font to 11. So let's delete this one, insert 11. So that we did before, right? And we're gonna get something like opacity. Let me see, where is it? Here. So background opacity. Let's uncomment this one. 80%. Yeah, let's leave it at that for now and see what we get. So let's quit out of the terminal, mod enter, and you still see that we don't have any opacity. So we have to set something in the config file, because we have to have set a compositor. So let's open Vim again. Vim.config i3 and then the config file. And let's go to the end, shift G. And we're gonna append, and we're gonna set here compositor, and we're gonna do exec --no --startup --id. And we install PyCam, I think, and set it to -f. Okay, I'm gonna save this. Let's locate PyCam. Let's see if I had installed it. No, so we have to install it. So PyCam is now installed and it should start when we log in. So Mod Shift R, because we set it to single, let's start it always. So let's set it to always underscore always. And restart i3, close the terminal, hold enter, and we still have no opacity. Okay, so because I'm in a virtual machine, we need to set something in the configuration file of PyCam to be able to use PyCam. Sudo where is the configuration file, etc, xd, okay. So vim and slash vsync, and we have to set that to false. Okay, we have to do that as sudo. So probably we have to log out, log back in. So here we are back, mod enter, and now you can see that we have an opacity in our background. So now we can see the background through the terminal. If I now go to the browser, you can see some nice some switching as well. So this is pretty good. So we done a couple of things now. And yeah, I will leave it at this for now. In the next video, we're gonna install the programs and maybe do something that makes the complete system maybe change the i3 status bar to i3 blocks. and said some nice things there. And I hope you like this video for now. And I will see you in the next one. Have fun with Linux, guys. Bye for now.